Hey folks, Andrew here with Viking Electronics. Have you been looking for a way to integrate different paging sources with your paging system? Then get excited, because that's what this video is all about. Installers who work often with paging systems tell me they always have an FXI-1A on hand. The FXI-1A Smart Paging Interface by Viking Electronics will turn any analog port into a 600 ohm line level audio signal and provide a contact closure. In this video, I'm going to take you through the FXI-1A's three paging modes, common wiring configurations, and product details. Viking regularly puts out this type of content, so please click subscribe if you haven't already, and stay tuned till the end of this video because I'm going to take you through connecting a voice over IP paging source to an analog paging system. Looking under the hood of the FXI-1A, you'll see three pots in the upper left corner: master volume control, page length timeout, and silence timeout. There are two LEDs on the FXI-1A circuit board. This one will light red to indicate the FXI-1A is powered, and this one lights up blue when the FXI-1A is in use. Along the right side of the circuit board is the screw terminal block with connections for night bell, background music input, Form C relay contact normally closed, common and normally open, 600 ohm audio output, and the audio input, which is where the FXI-1A connects to the paging source. Below that are five dip switches: enable operation on a page port, enable vox mode, and vox sensitivity, which are all used in selecting the FXI-1A's different modes, enable busy detect, and enable pre-page alert tone. This big switch here is the talk battery switch, which turns talk battery on and off. Last but not least, this is the 12-volt DC power input for the included power supply. The FXI-1A has three paging modes based on the type of port the paging source provides: FXS, FXO, and Vox. FXS mode is for ring trip paging, which means a page is initiated by placing a phone call. In FXS mode, the FXI-1A will detect the incoming ringing voltage, seize the line, and convert the incoming audio to a 600 ohm signal, which is sent to the paging system. To put the FXI-1A into FXS mode, switch the talk battery switch to FXS and make sure dip switches 4 and 5 are off. Connect the station port or extension to pins 1 and 2, and connect pins 3 and 4 to the amplifier's 600 ohm input. In FXS mode, the FXI-1A is powered by the talk battery provided by the incoming phone line, so the included power supply is only required if the ring voltage is low. If the FXS port does not provide a CPC or busy signal, the FXI-1A can appear to lock up, preventing use of the paging system. You can avoid this by enabling the silence timeout and setting the value between 2.5 to 10 seconds, or by enabling the page length timeout and setting the length between 5 seconds to 1 minute. If you plan on using a POTS line or similar type service with direct access to the public network as your paging source, I would strongly suggest you use the RAD-1A instead of the FXI-1A, because the RAD-1A has a paging access code and the FXI-1A does not. The paging access code prevents unauthorized access to your paging system by robocalls or people who misdial. FXO mode is used in applications when the paging source is a trunk port, like a single or multi-line analog phone, or a phone system with an available line port. The FXI-1A detects when the paging source comes off hook, then generates 30 volts DC talk battery to connect the paging source to the paging system. If you intend to page in FXO mode, toggle the talk battery switch to the FXO position and verify that dip switches 4 and 5 are off. Then connect the unused trunk port to pins 1 and 2. Pins 3 and 4 connect to the amplifier's 600 ohm audio input. FXO mode requires the use of the included 12-volt DC power adapter. This FXS, FXO extension, unused trunk port terminology is confusing to you. We did a video about the difference between FXS and FXO ports, and I would recommend watching that video after this is over and then coming back and reviewing this content. You're going to have much more confidence using the FXI-1A after a solid understanding of the difference between FXS and FXO ports. The last paging mode the FXI-1A offers is Vox mode, which is used when the paging source is providing 600 ohm audio, like a phone system's page port, a digital mass notification system, or certain microphones. The FXI-1A detects the incoming audio signal and sends that signal to the paging system. Switch the talk battery switch to FXS mode and dip switches 4 and 5 to on to enable Vox mode and page port operation. Connect the 600 ohm audio source to the FXI-1A's pins 1 and 2 and the amplifier's 600 ohm audio input to pins 3 and 4. The external 12 volt DC power supply is required in this mode as well. In all three of these modes, the FXI-1A's Form C relay contact on pins 5, 6, and 7 will change state during a voice page. In applications where an amplifier requires a page trigger, the normally open pin 5 and common pin 6 on the FXI-1A can be used to trigger the amplifier during a voice page. If the paging application includes background music, the FXI-1A's relay can be used to mute music during a voice page and unmute it after. Connect your paging source to pins 1 and 2, and connect pins 3 and 6 to the amplifier's 600 ohm input. Using a short length of wire, connect audio output pin 4 to normally open pin 5. Connect the background music source's 600 ohm audio output to pins 7 and 8 on the FXI-1A. When a voice page is initiated, normally closed pin 7 will open, muting the background music, and normally open pin 5 will close, allowing the voice page to flow through to the amplifier. After the page, the relay returns to its normal state and the background music resumes. So what do you do when you have an analog paging system and a voice over IP paging source? The solution is to configure a voice over IP extension and connect an analog terminal adapter or an analog gateway. The ATA or gateway can have either FXS or FXO ports because the FXI-1A is equipped to handle both types. That is one of the reasons paging system installers turn to the FXI-1A. So as I was editing this part of the video, it seemed really fitting that I should mention to you Viking makes model PA-IP, which is a paging device that will interface a voice over IP SIP paging source directly to a analog paging system. And you can do either unicast or endpoint paging, as well as multicast paging. I'll put a link to that in the description below. Definitely consider that as an option if you do have an IP paging source. All right, back to the video. If you're looking for more information and resources on IP paging, analog paging, and other paging equipment, the Viking Electronics YouTube channel is a great resource for you, and I definitely suggest you subscribe if you have not. I'm Andrew. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.